you know, we talk about following the science and following the experts and doing what health professionals tell us to do, but Fauci is not a health professional. He's a government worker, and he's been in there some extraordinary amount of time. So whether we like it or not, he's a political animal, and you can see it in his statements, because he wouldn't answer your questions, and he's taken every position on masks, as far as I can tell.
Right. One of the best tweets I saw the other day was that he seems to have an opinion on Tinder sex and baseball, but when it comes to whether or not you should march in a protest, whether that might be risky to your health, no opinion at all. Refuses to comment on whether or not if you're out in a big city with hundreds of other people protesting racism. In fact, there were actually people, I think, at the WHO who responded and said, well, if the cause is righteous, like protesting against racism, surely you can't catch the disease at those. And it's like, that just shows how political this
sounds
is.
A little medieval or something. Yeah,
really. You know, if your motive is good, you can't catch this disease. But I don't know. I don't think he's a bad person. I don't think his motives are bad. But he is a government doctor. He's only seeing the government perspective, and he's an incredibly cautious person. Yeah. And so he's unwilling. You know, that was my point. If we're going to talk about whether kids should go to school, shouldn't we bring up some statistics? Childhood mortality, shouldn't we discuss that? And even that, he didn't really want to discuss that because it is very, very unusual. The WHO had a scientist who came and she broadcast that. She said, according to this study, children are rarely getting this and rarely transmitting it. She linked to a scientific paper. I don't know if it was hers or someone else, but she's a scientist from the WHO. She's not from the right. She's not. She is a government scientist. She says this. Within a day, they made her apology, mal-type apology. I'm sorry. They had a sort of a struggle session with her. And then she apologizes. I'm so sorry. I spoke against the state. But then they took down the link. And so if you go to her press conference, you can find her still. Maybe you don't find her anymore, but for a while you could find her. But the link to the WHO study was taken down. And it's amazing all the stuff that's out there. All the stuff is being taken down.
Yeah.
And I'm not for having the government get involved, but it doesn't mean I'm not annoyed by, you know, all the stuff on hydroxychloroquine. You know, Twitter has decided that they are the preeminent scientists on Earth, and you can't, if you disagree with their consensus, by golly, it's not true, and you're spreading disinformation. And the truth of the matter is, and I try to be objective on this, I've got no dog in the fight on hydroxychloroquine. I don't care whether you take it or you don't take it. But the truth of the matter is this, the studies are probably equivocal. There's no blockbuster study saying it helps you. But there's also no definitive study saying it doesn't work.
Yeah.
Particularly in the early stages, we don't know. And the reason we don't know is it's a difficult study. So if I want to give a bunch of people a drug who don't yet have a disease, and only 5% of the public gets the disease, I got to study a lot of people over months, if not years, to figure it out. To figure out that aspirin prevented heart attacks, they studied like 10,000 doctors as subjects over like a 10-year period, and it's still only like a 5 or a 10% difference to see that aspirin works. But studies like that are very hard to determine. So I'd be the first to say I don't know on it, but I think it sort of, you know, goes against the grain of scientific method and skepticism and the whole thing to say, oh, we're just going to ban anybody who talks about it or any doctors who prescribe it. And then those who went crazy over the safety of it, well, I've taken it twice, or a derivative or a family of that drug for malaria prophylaxis, and so like 50 million people. All drugs have side effects. If you ever watch one of them on TV, it says, could cause nausea, vomiting, weight loss, cancer, even death. And meanwhile, millions of people are still taking it because it helps them with their diabetes or whatever. But it's a big mistake to succumb to that. But I think it's also a big mistake to then tell Twitter and Facebook they can't do it. I would say turn them off. Don't use them. If you don't like them, go to another venue.